At midnight, the Victorian Ambulance Service called a code red. For 3 hours, it did not have the staff to meet the extreme demand for medical care. The calls eased by 3 a.m, but the union says the strain on services is ongoing.
Paramedics are absolutely exhausted. The system is just being inundated on a daily basis.
SBS News understands 28 ambulances couldn't be staffed last night due to illness, including 6 intensive care vehicles. Health authorities calling on people to reserve 000 for emergencies.
It would be, I think, for people who have the milder symptoms to contact their GP, contact Nurse On Call. Nurse On Call is a terrific service that's provided free and is widely available.
It's an issue across the country as record infections again take too many essential workers out of action.
We've had a lot of reports of people dialing 000 the moment they get a diagnosis of COVID-19, even with very mild symptoms. And that really is causing a problem in many of our emergency departments, and it's not necessary.
Queensland leaders pleading with people to stay home unless they have these symptoms.
A significant breathlessness, significant chest pain, or fainting or significant dizziness. Those are the symptoms under which you should consider seeking medical advice or going to an emergency department.
In New South Wales, the staffing problem has been called the perfect storm. Peak sickness combining with the holiday period.
We have more than 3,000 staff yesterday who are impacted by furloughing.
The South Australian Premier says more than 500 health workers have been furloughed and almost half of those are COVID positive, but many have kept working from home.
Well, and they're supporting our community response team, supporting those people that are living with COVID in the community.
It's not only health workers that leaders are worried about. New South Wales is currently working on a plan to use rapid tests in schools to keep teachers in the classroom after the holidays.
The outcome that we want to see in our state is that we get kids back into the classroom day one, term one, in a safe way.
It comes as the return to work for 2022 was stalled for hundreds of families. 341 childcare centres were closed across Australia today due to COVID-19. Lucy Murray, SBS World News.